Hi, hello students, welcome to Indian Tech Guru for you. Let us move on to the next chapter. The next chapter is Computer Arithmetic. So let us start with the Computer Arithmetic. Already we know what is meant by Computer Arithmetic. So basically there are four different arithmetic operations from our childhood onwards we are discussing. So they are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So these are the four basic arithmetic operations we need to perform. So any other arithmetic operations we can derive from these four basic operations. So as well as the ALU, arithmetic logic unit. Arithmetic logic unit is the base for the CPU, central processing unit, in which it is going to perform the arithmetic, logic as well as the shift operations. So among these arithmetic, logic and shift operations, so the arithmetic operations are having special significance because these operations are needed for several programs and which are carried out by the arithmetic processor, which is a part of the arithmetic logic unit. So however, there are so many complications while actually performing these arithmetic operations. The complications are the data that is being represented to carry out the arithmetic operations, may be the binary data or the decimal data. So as far as the computers are concerned, the computers understand only the binary data. However, it is easier for the human beings to work with the decimal data. So however, one more complication is there. So that is, this particular data may be of fixed point representation or floating point representation. So fixed point representation means it may be an integer type of data. Floating point representation means it may be float or double type of data as far as the programming languages are concerned. So floating point means real numbers as far as the mathematics is concerned. So we need to represent both the fixed point as well as the floating point representation and perform the arithmetic operations. So as well as the data may be represented either in binary format or in the decimal format. So these are the things we need to take care before actually performing the arithmetic operations. Now we need to take care of these things before actually performing the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So what are the things we need to take care and what are the types of arithmetic operations we need to perform are, the first one is fixed point binary data in signed magnitude representation. We need to perform arithmetic operations on fixed point binary data in signed magnitude representation. So this is category 1, case 1. The case 2 is fixed point binary data in signed 2's complement representation. So already we know previously that we can represent the binary numbers in signed magnitude representation, in 1's complement representation and in 2's complement representation. So now we need to perform the operations, arithmetic operations for the fixed point binary data which is in signed magnitude representation. So signed magnitude representation is easier for the human beings, for us, because from childhood onwards we will be working with the signed magnitude representation. So however, fixed point binary data in signed 2's complement representation is easier for the computer system. So as computers can perform the binary arithmetic in 2's complement representation easily compared to signed magnitude representation. So that's why we need to consider these two cases. And we need to work with the floating point binary data to perform various arithmetic operations, and finally we need to perform arithmetic operations using decimal data. Directly we cannot perform using the decimal data, that is why we are going to use the binary coded decimal BCD representation. And using this BCD representation, how we are going to perform the arithmetic operations, we are going to see as the last case. So totally 4 cases we need to consider to perform these arithmetic operations. Case 1 is a fixed point binary data in signed magnitude representation. Case 2 is a fixed point binary data in signed 2's complement representation. Case 3 is a floating point binary data, and case 4 is binary coded decimal data. So already we know what is about binary coded decimal. We have codes from 0 to 9, the equivalent binary codes for the decimal numbers from 0 to 9. So we can directly convert the decimal number into binary equivalent using the binary coded decimal, and then perform arithmetic on the binary coded decimal data. So in this chapter we will be elaborating all these 4 different cases of cases and perform the arithmetic operations in each case. First let us start with the fixed point binary data in signed magnitude representation. So as far as the addition and subtraction are concerned, we can perform the addition as well as subtraction. So by the way, how we are going to represent the negative numbers? So negative numbers can be represented using signed magnitude, signed 1's complement, signed 2's complement representation. However, in the previous classes we discussed that it is easy to represent the negative numbers using signed 2's complement representation compared to other two representations. So even then it is our prime concern to know how to perform the addition as well as subtraction using the signed magnitude representation also. So for that purpose, what we are going to do is, so we are going to implement the addition as well as subtraction operations using the signed magnitude representation. However, you need to know that, so while implementing the signed magnitude representation, the input will be considered in signed magnitude representation and the output must be represented in the signed magnitude representation. In the intermediate calculations, we can use the 2's complement implementation. There is no problem for that. Okay. So our representation of signed magnitude resembles that. We need to input the numbers in signed magnitude and the output must be in signed magnitude. It doesn't mean that we should not use 2's complement representation in between. Okay. So it is important to be realized that the adopted representation for negative numbers refers to the representation of numbers in the registers before and after the execution of the arithmetic operation. It does not mean that complement arithmetic may not be used in the intermediate step. So you can use the complement arithmetic in the intermediate steps. That does not resemble that we are not using the signed magnitude. However, still if the input as well as output are in signed magnitude representation, so it means that we are using the signed magnitude representation. What does it internally means? Its internal meaning is we are going to use the 2's complement representation, 2's complement representation inside of the signed magnitude representation as an intermediate step, as an intermediate step that is allowable. Okay. So there is no conflict regarding the implementation of 2's complement representation as an intermediate step. Okay. So now we will see how we are going to implement the 2's complement as an intermediate step and perform the addition as well as subtraction in signed magnitude representation. So as far as the addition and subtraction operations with signed magnitude representation are concerned, we need to perform the following operations. So there will be 8 different conditions we need to consider to perform the signed magnitude representations addition as well as subtraction. So what are those 8 cases? The case 1, first case, case 1 is plus a plus plus b, plus a plus plus b. So it can be represented as, if you take the plus as common, plus of a plus b. Plus of a plus b. What does it mean? Add a and b, and the resultant sign is plus. The result sign is plus. Okay. Next, case 2. Case 2 is plus a plus minus b. Plus a plus minus b. Okay. So here there are totally 3 different cases when a is greater than b. For example, assume plus 10 plus minus 6. Plus 10 plus minus 6. Here a value is 10, b value is 6. So a is greater than b. So whenever a is greater than b, how we can modify this particular plus a plus plus minus b? Plus of a minus b. Plus of a minus b. What does it mean? Just perform a minus b and put the plus sign. And put the plus sign. So the plus sign is a sign. Okay. Put the a sign for the result. Okay. Next, when a is less than b, for example, assume the operation is plus 6 plus minus 10. So here a value is 6, b value is 10. Now a is less than b. So whenever a is less than b, then how to calculate? Then you need to calculate b minus a. B minus a. B minus a means 10 minus 6. 10 minus 6 is 4. Okay. 10 minus 6 is 4. And put a minus sign. Put a minus sign. So for the result, that is, the result is minus 4. Plus 6 plus minus 10 is minus 4. We know. Okay. So this should be the result after performing the plus a plus minus b operation. And the case 3. In case 2, the third condition is when a is equal to b. So that means plus 10 plus minus 10. Plus 10 plus minus 10. Then we need to perform a minus b and put a plus sign. So before the result. Before the result. Okay. So these are the 3 internal cases for the case 2. For case 2, there are 3 internal cases. When a is greater than b, when a is less than b, and when a is equal to b. Okay, these 3 are the internal cases we need to perform. Okay. Next, case 3. Case 3 is minus a plus plus b. Minus a plus plus b. Okay. If this is the condition, so minus a plus plus b means minus 10 plus plus 6. If this is the condition, then when a is greater than b, here 10 is greater than 6. So if that is the condition, perform a minus b. 10 minus 6, 4. And put a sign. What is a sign? Minus. So minus of a minus b, we should calculate. Okay. Similarly, so if this is the condition, that is, if a is less than b, that is minus 6 plus plus 10. A is 6, b is 10. A is less than b. If a is less than b, then what we need to perform? B minus a. 10 minus 6. 10 minus 6 is 4. And put plus sign. How to put a plus sign? Plus sign is b sign. Put b sign. Okay. So this is the case. Next, when a is equal to b, perform a minus b and then put a plus sign. So whenever a is equal to b, you need not to bother at all. Okay. Because both the values are equal, always you are going to get the zero value. So because zero should not be minus, so there should not be any minus zero. That is why always put a plus sign. Always put a plus sign. Okay. So next, case 4. Case 4 is minus a plus minus b. Minus a plus minus b. If that is the case, then perform a plus b. That is minus 10 plus minus 6. Then perform a plus b. 10 plus 6, 16. And put a minus sign. What is minus sign? A sign. A sign is minus. So minus, calculate minus of a plus b. Okay. So this is the case. Like this, we can derive the other cases also, case 5, case 6, case 7, and case 8. The other cases you can derive similarly. So as far as all these cases are concerned, we need to conclude that if you keenly observe all the different cases, ultimately what we need to find, ultimately we need to find either a plus b, okay, so either a plus b, these are the four cases where a plus b is there, or you need to calculate a minus b, a minus b. So this one, 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 all these are a minus b, or you need to calculate b minus a, b minus this one, this one, this one, this one. So ultimately you need to determine which sign you need to place, which sign you need to place before the result, okay. All these are the results. Before the result, which sign must be placed, you need to determine, okay. So using by considering these 8 different conditions, let us develop an algorithm for performing the addition as well as subtraction, addition as well as subtraction for the signed magnitude representation. So before actually deriving the algorithm, we need to know what is the hardware configuration needed for signed magnitude addition as well as subtraction. So here we need a register, we need b register, two registers we need. A will store the content of operand a, a register will contain the content of operand a, b register will contain the content of operand b, okay. Now if we keenly observe the previous table, we need to perform either a plus b or a minus b, either a plus b or a minus b. B minus a is equivalent to minus of a minus b, so we need not to consider, we need not to worry about the b minus a, because b minus a is equal to minus of a minus b. So that's why ultimately what we need to do, we need to find out either a plus b or a minus b. So these are two operations we need to perform. So how to perform a plus b? Very simple. So as we have seen in the previous classes, we need parallel adder circuits to perform the addition operation, that we have already seen in the previous classes. So this is the parallel adder which is going to perform the addition. It knows how to perform the addition. However, the inputs must be a register as well as b register in case of a plus b, a plus b. So for that purpose, we are going to use a mode control m. Whenever m is equal to 0, m value is 0, then directly b register will be moved to the parallel adder. So a register will be moved from here and b register will be moved directly to the parallel adder. So because m is equal to 0, the same content will be moved and a plus b is performed using the parallel adder. However, for performing a minus b, we need to perform a plus b complement plus 1. So for that purpose, we will be giving m value as 1, then it is going to perform the complement of b. So now once you perform complementer, it will be b dash or b bar. Then because m value is input as input carry, now plus 1 will be added. So automatically we will get for the parallel adder a plus b complement plus 1, so which is equal to a minus b. So now the parallel adder itself is going to perform the a minus b operation. Like this it is going to perform. Ultimately the sum of a register as well as b register will be moved to a register, okay, will be moved to a register. What does it mean? Ultimately a contains a plus b value. So a is going to from here, b is coming from here, the parallel adder is going to add or subtract. Ultimately the result will be moved to a register, okay. Then what about the signed bits? because it is signed magnitude representation, we need to maintain the sign bits separately. That is very, very important. The sign bit of A is maintained in AS, a flip-flop AS. The sign bit of B is maintained in a flip-flop BS. And the output carry is stored in a flip-flop E, expansion bit. And the add overflow flip-flop will be there. So, which will contain the add overflow, if any. If any add overflow occurs, then it will be represented by AVF, add overflow. So, when overflow occurs, we have seen in the first unit. So, what is meant by overflow and when the overflow occurs. Okay. So, this is the hardware structure needed to perform the addition as well as subtraction. So, with the signed magnitude representation. So, once we know the hardware for signed magnitude addition and subtraction, now we can derive an algorithm for performing the addition as well as subtraction and see how these operations are performed. Now, this is the algorithm which is represented in flowchart to perform the both the addition operation as well as the subtract operation. Okay. So, as and when needed. So, as we have seen previously, even though there are 8 different combinations, case 1, case 2, case 3, case 4, case 5, case 6, case 7, case 8, all these combinations can be represented with only 2 operations, either A plus B or with A minus B. A minus B means A plus B complement plus 1. So, as we have seen previously, even though it is signed magnitude representation, it is allowed to use the 2's complement representation as intermediate step. Ultimately, the final result must be in signed magnitude representation. So, that is very, very important. So, first let us go through the case 1 and see how the operation is performed. Case 1 is plus A plus plus B. Assume A is equal to 10, B is equal to 10, A's sign is plus. A sign is plus and B sign is plus. That is AS is equal to 0, BS is equal to 0. Okay. So, A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 6. Consider B is equal to B as 6. Then what operation we need to perform? Plus A plus plus B. That is plus 10 plus plus 6. So, AS, BS, 0, 0 sign bits, then A is 10, B is 6. 10 means consider 8 bit registers, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Next, 6 means 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So, these are the values given. Now, see the operation, see the flow chart. If it is add operation or subtraction operation, it is add operation. And they augment in A and added in B. A value is 10, B value is 6. So now initially perform AS exclusive or BS. AS exclusive or BS. So that is 0 exclusive or 0. And the result will be 0. So if it is 0, what does it mean? AS is equal to BS. If AS is equal to BS, then what we need to do is perform the A plus B operation. Perform the A plus B operation and store in EA. EA. EA means E register, E flip flop and A register. E flip flop and A register. Okay. So, A register is nothing but this register only. And after updating the result will be stored in A itself. Okay. So, now perform A plus B. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay. So, E bit will be by default 0. So, now there is no disturbance in E bit. E will be 0 itself. So, add overflow is assigned to E. So, now add overflow will be 0. That is no overflow occurred. Okay. No overflow occurred. And this result will be stored in A. Now from here, it will be going to end, and in the end what we are saying, result is in A and AS. So this is the result. What is the result? 16. 1 2 4 8 16. 16 is the result. And what is the symbol? AS symbol is the symbol for the result. That is 0 is the symbol. That is 0 means positive. Plus 16. Plus 16 is the result. Okay. Plus 16 is the result. So case 1, like this we are going to perform the case 1. In case 1, what we traced? We traced with this line. Okay. So this one from here to here. Performed A plus B. And then performed here. So this particular tracing is completed. Okay. Now let us go for the case 2. Case 2. So case 2 is plus A plus minus B. Values are same. Case 2 is plus A plus minus B. Plus 10 plus minus 6. Okay. This is the second case. As far as the second case is concerned, three internal cases are there. So the first internal case is when A is greater than B. Now what is the value of A? 10. Value of B? 6. So 10 is greater than 6. True or false? True. So what we need to perform? We need to perform this operation. Okay. So however, we need to perform this operation by tracing in the flow chart. Okay. So now for that purpose, so let us fill the values. AS is plus, BS is minus. So BS minus means it will be 1. Okay. So AS is 0, BS is 1, and A value plus 10, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and BS is minus 6. So BS is minus 6 means what to do. So before actually knowing what to do, let us trace in the flow chart. So whether AS, BS perform the exclusive OR, then you will get one value. So if it is 1, then what to do? Go to this particular path. This particular path represents that AS not equal to BS. AS not equal to BS. If A is not equal to BS, then what to do? Then perform A plus B complement plus 1. What does it mean? Calculate A minus B. Calculate A minus B. Okay. So now for that purpose, so we know what is A value, but we need to perform B complement. B complement plus 1. That is 2's complement of B. So what is B value? The B value is 0, 0, 0, 0, 6 together. 6 means 0, 1, 1, 0. Now we need to find out the 2's complement equivalent of this number. So that is 0, we encountered the first 1, then exchange. 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is the 2's complement representation of B value. Now perform the addition operation. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay. So now the result has come. So what is the result? The result has come as 4. Okay, 10 minus 6 is 4. The result has come correctly as 4. But what about the sign bit? For sign bit, we need to check the E bit value, check the expansion bit value. So now you can see the expansion bit is 1. E bit is 1. If E bit is 1, then A is greater than or equal to B. So now A value is 4. It is not equal to 0. So because A value is not equal to 0, then finally we got the output. So what is the output? The output will be in A as well as AS. So what is the value of A? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, This is the value of A. And what is A is? A is 0. 0. A is. So that is the final result is plus 4. Plus 4 is the final result. Okay. So this is the internal case 1 of case 2. Okay. So now let us move on to the internal case 2. Internal case 2 of case 2. So what is that internal case 2 of case 2? If A is less than B. If A is less than B. So A is less than B means the value of A must be less than the value of B. Now we should take A as 6, A as 6 and B as 10. Okay. So the operation is same. A s will be 0 and B s will be 1. That is same. Okay. Now, so if that is the case, then how to perform? Now check AS and BS. Perform the exclusive OR of AS and BS 0, 1. So it will be 1. So if it is 1, then what we need to do? We need to perform this operation. A plus B complement plus 1. So here A value is 6, B value is 10. So, what is the value of 6? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Now, we need to find out minus B. Minus B means B complement plus 1. So, what is the B value? 10. That is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. What is the 2's complement of this, this value? 0, first one encountered, exchange. 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is the 2's complement. Now perform the addition. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and the expansion bit 0. Okay. So now we got the answer. However, the answer will be in 2's complement representation. The answer will be in 2's complement representation, which should not be because we are actually performing the sign magnitude addition and subtraction. So that is why we need to convert this 2's complement representation into sign magnitude representation. Now, what is the expansion bit value? Expansion bit value is 0. So now we need to come to this path. Because A is less than B. A value is 6, B value is 10, 6 is less than 10. So we go through this particular path. And now we need to convert the 2's complement representation into original representation. Original representation. Okay. So what is the original representation? The original representation is once again perform the 2's complement representation for this one. That is how we are going to perform. Here you can see A assignment A dash, A assignment A plus 1. That is A assignment A dash plus 1, A complement plus 1. That is whatever the result we got, perform the 2's complement for this particular result. Then what we are going to get? So 0, 0, first 1 and then exchange 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So what is this value? This value is 4, which is in signed magnitude representation. So then what about the sign value, sign bit value? What about the sign value? The sign value is, actually the sign value is AS. AS is 0, but whenever we perform plus 6 plus minus 10, what we are going to get? Plus 6 plus minus 10, we are going to get minus 4. So the result must have the minus value. So however, now if you put the AS symbol here, the result will have a plus value. So what we need to do, we need to change the sign bit also. That's why this particular statement AS assignment AS bar. Okay, AS assignment AS bar. So that is this zero value will be converted into 1. So what should be the result? Final result minus 4. This minus 4 is in 2's complement representation. That is why even though we have used this minus 4 is not in 2's complement, it is in assigned magnitude representation. So that is why even though we have used the 2's complement representation as an intermediate step, it doesn't matter. The final output is in assigned magnitude representation. That is very, very important. Okay, that what we discussed previously. Okay, now we traced this particular path, we traced this particular path, we traced this particular path. So let us trace this path. So to trace that particular path, so we need to consider the internal case 3, internal case 3 of case 2. So what is the internal case 3 of case 2? A and B values are same. A and B values are same. So that is A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 10. And what is the operation? Plus A plus minus B. Plus 10 plus minus 10. So AS is equal to 0, BS is equal to 1 and A is 10, B is 10. So then what to do? So if you perform the exclusive OR, then you are going to get 1. So go through this particular path, then perform A minus B. Perform A minus B. So if you perform 10 minus 10, what you are going to get? You are going to get all zeros, isn't it? So you are going to get all zeros that we already know. So plus 10 means 0, 0, 0, 0. 1 0 1 0, minus 10 means 2's complement of this one, 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 1, if you add 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0, so in E beta you will have 1. So whenever you are having 1 in E beta, then you have to check whether A is greater than B or A is equal to B. Now, in this case, A is equal to B. A is 10, B is 10. A is equal to B. So, whenever A is equal to B, then what change you need to do is just change the AS, assign the AS, that is the resultant sign bit to 0. Because there should not be negative 0. Always there should be positive 0. So this is the path we come across now. Assign 0 to AS. Then what will be the result? Plus 0 will be the result. Okay. So these are the three cases in case 2 internal cases. Case 2 internally there are three cases. When A is greater than B, when A is less than B, and when A is equal to B. Okay. So like this we can go through all the remaining cases. All the remaining cases and trace out the algorithm. Okay, and trace out the algorithm. Similarly, whatever I have shown, how to trace the algorithm. We have gone through this particular path. We have gone through this particular path. We have gone through this particular path, and we have gone through this particular path. All paths literally we have gone through. When we are going through this particular path. Is whenever we are going to get the exclusive of AS and BS as 0. Then we are going to go through this particular path. Okay. So that is the case when we are going to get plus A minus plus B. Plus A minus plus B. Then also we are going to calculate A minus B itself. So there will be again three internal cases for this particular operation also. So like this, for all the combinations we can derive the result. So what are the internal representations? So as far as the addition is concerned, 1, 2, 3, 4 representations are there. As far as the subtraction is concerned, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 representations are there. As far as equivalence is concerned, 1, 2, 3, 4 representations are there. For all these representations, this particular algorithm is enough. Okay, for all these different combinations, this particular algorithm is enough. Using this particular flowchart, we can perform signed magnitude addition as well as subtraction. I have shown how to perform in case 1 and case 2 and 3 internal cases of case 2. Like this, you can trace out the remaining cases and see whether this particular circuit is working, this particular flowchart is working properly or not. So, like this, we are going to implement the addition and subtraction in signed magnitude representation. So, however, as we have previously discussed, in signed magnitude representation, we are not going to actually implement in the computer system. The computer system is going to implement in two's complement representation. So, now let us briefly see how to represent the two's in two's complement representation. So, for two's complement representation, the hardware required is very simple. We need not bifurcate the sign symbol because we have previously discussed that in case of 2's complement representation, we are going to convert the given number including the sign bit to the 2's complement. So, that's why we need accumulator register, we need BR register and we need complementer and parallel adder. So, there will be one overflow flip-flop. So, this is the hardware needed for signed 2's complement addition as well as subtraction. So, as we need not to represent the symbols separately, that is the sign bits separately. So, as far as the addition and subtraction are concerned, so it is very easy to perform the addition and subtraction in case of the 2's complement representation. If it is addition, then perform AC assignment AC plus BR and assign overflow to the V bit, V flip-flop. So, as far as the subtraction is concerned, perform AC assignment AC plus BR bar plus 1, that is AC minus BR, and assign overflow to the V flip flop. That's it. So, using these two simple operations, we are going to perform the addition and subtraction in case of the 2's complement representation. So, that is why, because 2's complement representation is easier compared to the signed magnitude representation, the computers are going to use the 2's complement representation for performing the addition as well as subtraction. Hope you like this video. That's all for now.